from the historic Loretto Abbey Chapel. With the kind cooperation of the Toronto Catholic District School Board, the National Catholic Broadcasting Council presents the Daily TV Mass.
Welcome to the celebration of the Daily TV Mass. I'm Father Henk van Mijl. The televising of this Mass is made possible by the contribution from our donors. The first is Sinaida Ribello from Mississauga, Ontario, for living and deceased family and friends, for strengthening of faith and for peace. The Daily TV Mass ministry is made possible by the generous contribution of all our donors, and in a special way our monthly donors. In a month dedicated to the holy name of Jesus, we pray as a community of faith that his name will bring peace and reconciliation to our families and the world. Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass. Today, we also pray as a community for the repose of the soul of Spiritan Father Pat Fitzpatrick, who died peacefully in the early morning hours of December the 7th, 2023. During his 70 years of religious life and his 60 years as a priest, Father Pat made many important contributions to Catholic education in Ontario and to the life of the Spiritan province of Trans-Canada, as well as positively impacting the lives of innumerable people with his gentle and thoughtful pastoral care. Father Pat was a regular celebrant of the Daily TV Mass for over 20 years and was also a retreat leader on several national Catholic missions, and his reflections on the way of the cross is a favorite of our community. We give thanks for the gift of Father Pat, a good and faithful servant. May he rest in peace, and may perpetual light shine upon him. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And as we have placed ourselves before the Lord on this memorial of Saint Hilary, again recalling that we're weak people, just like Saint Hilary 1600 years ago, knowing that he was weak, knowing that he needed God's guidance at every breath he took. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we may rightly understand and truthfully possess the divinity of your Son, which the Bishop Saint Hilary taught with such constancy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. There was a man of Benjamin whose name was Kish, son of Abiel, son of Zeror, son of Becherah, son of Alphia, a Benjaminite, a man of wealth. He had a son whose name was Saul, a handsome young man. There was not a man among the people of Israel more handsome than he. He stood head and shoulders above everyone else. Now the donkeys of Kish, Saul's father, had strayed. So Kish said to his son Saul, "Take one of the boys with you. Go out and look for the donkeys." He passed through the hill country of Ephraim and passed through the land of Shalisha, but they did not find them. And they passed through the land of Shalim, but they were not there. And they passed through the land of Benjamin, but they did not find them. When Samuel saw Saul, the Lord told him, "Here is the man of whom I spoke to you. He it is who shall rule over my people." Then Saul approached Samuel inside the gate and said, "Tell me, please, where is the house of the seer?" Samuel answered Saul, "I am the seer. Go up before me to the shrine, for today you shall eat with me, and in the morning I will let you go. And I will tell you all that is on your mind." Samuel took a vial of oil and poured it on his head and kissed him. He said, "The Lord has anointed you the ruler over his people Israel. You shall reign over the people of the Lord, and you will save them from the hand of their enemies all around." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus went out beside the sea. The whole crowd gathered around him, and he taught them. As he was walking along, he saw Levi, son of Alphaeus, sitting at the tax booth. And he said to him, "Follow me." And he got up and followed him. And as Jesus sat at dinner in Levi's house, many tax collectors and sinners were also sitting with Jesus and his disciples, for there were many who followed him. When the scribes of the Pharisees saw that he was eating with sinners and tax collectors, they said to his disciples, "Why does he eat with tax collectors and sinners?" When Jesus heard this, he said to them, "Those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick do. I have come to call not the righteous, but sinners." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The calling of Levi, of course, the tax collector, many of us will know that it's also it's the same as Matthew, the tax collectors in other Gospels. But it's interesting how Jesus always says, I have come to call not the righteous, but sinners. And it's so, in my own life, that's where I often, my faith gets really touched and boosted. When I see major conversions, especially at Manresa Retreat Center, we do a lot with 12-step, so Alcohol Anonymous, eating disorders, sex addiction is a big one in these days, and so on. And how sometimes, drug addiction, of course, and how often those who are the outcast of society, they have the biggest conversions. And sometimes in spiritual direction, as I have the privilege to receive the faith, it really is strengthens my faith to see that. And so conversion is part of life. And sometimes the ones with the biggest conversions become the greatest examples for others. But God can use anyone. And we often forget that. If someone says, "I'm not good enough," think again. God uses everyone. We just have to have that conversion and say yes. Just the fiat, just like Mary said to the Gabriel, "Yes, I accept, do as you desire. Use me according to your desire." And the more we can say that, the more God will use each one of us for the good of God's vineyard, of course. And today we celebrate Saint Hilary, bishop in France. Hilary, who was married actually when he had his conversion. He already had a child. Actually, his child became also a saint. But a great conversion and eventually became bishop and a great defender of the faith against Arianism. Arianism was a great heresy in those times and also a political problem. And so there were, shall we say, many strong discussions. I think a few people got killed too, but anyway, that's the history of the church. But Arianism, they denied actually the divinity of Christ. They said, and there were different forms of Arianism, but they said it attacks the Trinity as Jesus is not God. Jesus is not God. And a stream of Arianism we find today in Islam, in our Muslim sisters and brothers, who see Jesus as a prophet, but not the Son of God. And so, but Saint Hilary was very much used for that. And at one point they exiled him, the Arians exiled him to the east of the empire, and they could not stand him there either. They couldn't shut him up. So they sent him back to France, so he continued his ministry. And he was bishop for 18 years and really made a great example. And in the same way, we celebrate today Father Pat Fitzpatrick, I'm sorry, and who made his own impression on the church. Of course, he's known for 20 years of presiding here at our very own TV mass and touching probably tens of thousands, maybe even millions of people in his ministry over the years. But making that, he said yes early on in his life too. I do not know his conversion, but he must have said yes in his early life and immigrated from Ireland to Canada in 1964. And he went on to become an educator, very strong in education, and also an adult faith consultant for the Dufferin Peel School Board, and so on, and became a provincial or superior of the Spiritan province in Canada. But always, It comes after conversion. When there's a conversion, we don't look back anymore. Everything changes. Everything changes. We literally see the blind are healed. We literally see with different eyes. And what was important in the past is not important anymore. And we become signs for others. Just like I witness so often in the 12-step movement, and especially with Alcohol Anonymous, where there is great conversions, where people are utterly lonely in their addiction. And when God touches their heart, when Jesus says, just like to Levi, come, come, I can use you, then everything changes and we become that great sign of God for others. Amen. So let us bring our prayers before the Lord. We pray for all those in our daily TV Mass prayer intention book. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In a month dedicated to the holy name of Jesus, we pray as a community of faith that his name will bring peace and reconciliation to our families and the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray, with Pope Francis, we pray that the Holy Spirit may help us to recognize the gift of different charism within the Christian community and to discover the richness of different traditions and rituals in the Catholic Church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And lastly, we pray for the reposed soul of Father Pat Fitzpatrick, who has blessed our TV Mass community for many years as one of our celebrants. We pray to the Lord. And for these prayers, and the prayers in the silence of our own hearts, we lift them up to you, Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, the mere sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquities. Cleanse me of my sins. Thank you. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the glory of his
nation. May the sacrifice which we gladly present on the feast day of Blessed Hilary be pleased to you, O God, for taught by him, we too give ourselves entirely to you in praise, through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of Saint Hilary you bid your church rejoice, so too strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Francis, our Bishop, the order of bishops, the clergy, and the entire people you have called your own. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. And at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom of God. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And
let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Take away the
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Please join me now in this act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in this holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I passionately desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my soul, so that I may unite myself wholly to you, now and forever. Amen.
And let us pray. Through Christ the teacher, O Lord, instruct those you feed with Christ the living bread, that on the feast day of Blessed Hilary they may learn your truth and express it in words of charity. Through Christ, O Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass.